Hello and welcome to a brand new show of Watch Up. I'm Anam Mirza and today we have with us someone extremely special. Someone who can make anyone laugh till they cry. Today we have with us Mr. Cyrus Brocha.
Hello Cyrus, welcome to our show. First of all, thank you for being here.
Can I just say I want to apologize because I'm not the couch. The couch is separate. I just look like a part of the couch.
No, you look just fine.
That's the couch, that's me.
You look just fine. Okay, so just my first question to you is, you started at a very early age. We've read somewhere that you started, your first thing that you did was in school, and after that when you were 12 you...
Let me explain that. See, my mother, like all middle class mothers in urban cities, they think that especially sons are the greatest invention since the Aryabhatta Zero. And so, I think long ago, somebody called up for some event and said, give us a biodata, which is so embarrassing.
Yeah.
I'm sure you get that also all the time.
Yeah.
And some people like to write all... So, if the mother's writing, my mother wrote 4 years, he took part in this, like maybe Mozart, and 8 years, he won potato race, and 12 years, he shaved himself for the first time. All ridiculously embarrassing things. So, that's not all true. I just did school plays like anybody else did in school. It's nothing great.
We also read that he used to write in school. Is that also one?
But again, that's why you go to school, to write.
No, I think like he used to write for your magazine.
Yeah, I wrote a little bit. Like, yeah. But then there are lots of kids who did that. You know, you just it was not about talent. It was just those interested in writing.
Okay.
And so, you know, it's something to do to kill time.
Okay. So how did comedy happen to you?
Oh, comedy didn't happen. I personally, I'm a very straight actor. Unfortunately, I can't get any work. And I'm... an LLB 1 year, which I tell everyone.
Yeah.
But I have the option of finishing my LLB. Also, if you've seen that jolly LLB or that my cousin Vinny or whatever, I can, with a book, you know, defend you. So if you have a legal problem and you have no money, I'm the guy. We are the people to go
to. Yes, exactly.
Awati odd, if you go back, it doesn't look so bad. But at 42, if you go back, they think the professor's uncle has come visiting. So it's a little embarrassing.
You can be like that English wing with Sridevi. Who goes to learn English.
I'm glad you look at me and think of Sridevi.
Okay, Cyrus, so we've seen you in one movie which did extremely well, and after that we haven't seen you in too many movies, and it's not because you don't get work, but...
No, I don't get work. It's not easy. The thing about films, there are two problems. One is we get these B-grade, if you're not a big star, they give you these already odd scripts and really strange movies to act in. One guy came with a script called Bakra about a year back. And it was ridiculous. It was just double entendre sexual humor, which he thought was very funny. And I was like, this is written by a 13-year-old boy in any school.
Yeah.
It was very scary. So that's one thing. The other thing is they lock us up if you act in a movie for so much time with very little money.
Yeah.
So, but please, and I'm looking at moving down south now.
Okay.
And
that's
working
a good thing.
As a, since I look like Sridevi, maybe there's hope.
Cyrus, I remember this one time, I think I was 6-7 and you were in Calcutta at this WTA tournament, and I saw somebody got very offended because you stopped them from going on court.
We didn't bakra. See, when you do candid camera stuff, remember one thing, we can only execute it. The idea was Mahesh's gang, I think Mahesh's gang was doing it. And I can't remember everybody involved, but there was some foreign WTA lady.
I think Rodionova or somebody.
I'm not sure who. So we put our trust in them. But the problem is some of these females are very alpha female type tennis players. I don't want to say that, you know, talk about sexual gender and all that.
Yeah.
But one was very aggressive. I remember she was twice my size. I was so scared. But by and large, there were some nice girls also who took it quite sportingly. But yeah, there were a couple of incidents. But this was Sunfeast Open. And it was not... See, we just come and execute it hope that everything goes well.
Okay, so there must be a lot of times when people actually take offense like that girl also. Like, I'm sure there must have been so many instances.
Not so many. There are a few.
Hmm.
With the lower class of society, it's a little easier because once you explain what's happening, they're very happy to be on TV. But with society, you know, urban people who are, you know, educated and all, for some reason, they don't take it sportingly sometimes.
Yeah.
So we can't air it. That's happened a lot. And then we get flack when we do these shows that, you know, it's like an elitist show where the richer urban people are shooting gags on poorer people who can't really understand what's going on. But the fact of the matter is, every time we try to get people like us from our class of society, it's a 50-50 chance of putting it on air because they just object.
Okay. You've interviewed everyone, like from Shah Rukh to Amitabh to most of the Bollywood actors. And I mean, is there somebody that you haven't interviewed and would love to do? Interviewed as in your gang?
Kareena Kapoor, I've not interviewed.
Really?
Amir Khan, I've not interviewed, but I've interacted with him at one shoot or something, I can't remember.
That'll be funny too.
Amir likes very serious questions and all that, and so that would be, take a long time to get done to anything. And he came dressed as Mangal Pandey for, I think Sophie Chaudhary did the interview finally. And I kept laughing, he looked really funny with that mustache and talking normally in English. like to other people dressed like that. It was really funny. So the women, I really enjoyed interviewing the girls. The young generation are very sharp, so they always say the right things on camera and all that. But the old generation...
Have you done Ranbir and stuff?
No, Ranbir Kapoor, no, I don't think so. I met him once at the Bombay gym recently, about a year back. And my good friend Kunal went up to him and Kunal had a few drinks and said hello. And he called him sir. Ranbir called him sir and said, sir, how are you? So Kunal said, come to the bar and join us. And Ranbir said, I don't drink. So Kunal said, Kapoor doesn't drink, what a waste. And walked off. So after that, I never meet him again. It's quite embarrassing.
Okay, so Cyrus, you do so many things, like you do the MTV Bakra and then you do this news thing at CNN and you know, I mean, there's such diverse things, you've written a book, so how do you manage all this?
Well, books you just have to copy from the internet. The other stuff, basically we have on television, we have to earn money to pay bills. I've got two hungry children, and I mean hungry, and two old parents and a German Shepherd, so all this costs money. But we're lucky enough, I think, to be in a generation where TV is, you know, pushing boundaries and allowing us to get work in different spheres and all that. Unfortunately, in MTV at 42, it's tough to be on a YouTube channel for long. But there's a show we're trying to do.
Okay, so Cyrus, there's this one game which we play with all our guests. Okay. So it's a 1 minute game.
It's not a physical game because I can't move. And I'm Sridevi.
It's a 1 minute game where I tell you a word and you tell me the first thought that comes to your mind. I'm sure you're going to be amazing at this.
Okay, put pressure. Nice. Then?
Okay, so the game starts now. Comedy.
Johnny Lever.
Tav.
Johnny Lever.
Aisha.
Used to be Johnny Lever, unfortunately. Yeah,
kids.
Aisha. That's my wife's name. Now you've taken the comedy out of the show. Now I'm sweating again.
Okay, your kids.
Kids, hopefully, if there are any and I'm responsible, I apologize. But you know, sometimes things happen. Especially when you're working hard and sweating a lot.
Okay. Passion.
Asleep. Food. Not working. Food. But I'm a Leo and I like being lazy. I
have to say one word.
Oh, I, that's tough. Can I make up a word like bulaka?
Okay. Gym.
I like the gym. I do spend time in the gym, unfortunately. I don't know why. But after marriage, there are lots of ways you spend the day trying to escape certain responsibilities. Gym is one of them.
Okay, shoot.
Hopefully, I don't have to anymore. But, you never know. Shooting in India, generally, winter, if it's cold, is much better. Hot conditions, it's not fun at all.
Acting.
In life, there's more acting to do.
Bollywood?
A character actor at 60.
Okay, you're done. Yo, Ink to Change!
This has been a great honor for me, being on Ink to Change. I was mistaken for Sridevi. An honest mistake by Anam. And I have to just say that this was a great honor being here. This is arguably the high point of my career. And the conveyance that you promised me, that will come in handy because I have to go back to Banjara Hills police station and declare myself every 3 or 4 hours. I used to be a woman and now I'm a man. I used to be a successful Bollywood star with a white sari and now I'm a man in a black suit. And I look a little bit more like Ajay Jadeja. Anand Sami and Ajay Jadeja had a kid, I'm that child. Something like that. But it's been a privilege and as you can see it's raining in Hyderabad. And it's raining only on my side. You seem fine.
Thank you for coming.
And she's a pistol expert, so any man who dates her, remember she's a national champion at pistol shooting. So if you have problems with her, do it on SMS because if you're close by up to what, 40 feet, 80 feet, the pistol range.
Yeah,
and if she doesn't shoot you properly, then it's for the rest of your life, pain and... I know because I used to be a woman. I know exactly what that's all about.
Look at you, my God, okay? Before I let you go,
it's
going
like
to...
Karan show.
Yeah, it's just a smaller version of Karan show where we use just one camera and...
And you don't get the big stars. It's okay. You don't get the
Okay, so can you sign it for us, please?
Oh, God. Okay. But I can't. I mean, this is like a cave drawing.
It's fine. Thank you so much, Cyrus. Thank you. Thank you for coming.
You're welcome. And Ink to Change, right?
Yeah.
Ink to Change is going to start a revolution. And remember, if you're looking for sponsors, I know lots of people with money.
Please call me now. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned to www.inktochange.com.